Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Hey guys, Sam Pardee here, and I'm going to be playing some Modern with a pretty sweet little Naya creature combo deck. The goal is to get a Restoration Angel into play with this feisty little goblin here, and make infinite Restoration Angels and kill your opponent. Obviously, it's also a Court of Calling deck, so that usually means that you also have the fair value game plan, although this deck is a little less focused on that. You just have... You know, you don't have too many like creatures that are that good at attacking and blocking because you're playing all these Wall of Omens, which you can blink with your Resto. So you can still definitely kill that way, but I would say you're more focused on the combo than the average, than like the Malira deck, or I guess now it's an Anafenza deck, than that sort of deck. You also have Domri as sort of your new pod replacement, which is very powerful. Obviously, it's not as powerful as Pod, but very, very powerful if you can cast it on turn two. So, let's get to some games. All right, here we are for round one, and we're on the draw with an obviously unkeepable hand. This hand, I think, is probably a keep, even though it's not great. If we draw a second land, we can cast a turn three Domri, even though we're pretty far away from casting a Linvala, actually. Yeah, I think it's not great, but I think this is a keep, unfortunately. Ooh, our opponent has some sweet... This is like Tempest Remastered, maybe? I don't even know how to make it tell me that. But anyway, sweet basics. Alright, great. That was actually a really good draw. Now we can just get a green-white land for our Wall of Roots and then play the Linval off of that. So that's actually ideal. Weird. Really strange. Fetched, untapped, and passes. I kind of feel like I might get Shadow of Doubted here. No, I guess not. I don't know, just that line just gives me like a weird feeling. I'll play the Firelit Thicket, I guess. I don't know what is going on exactly, but I don't like it. I don't know why you shock yourself there. Like, main phase fetch shocked myself, and then just didn't use the mana at all. Didn't remand us, didn't do anything. Very strange. So, I mean, I think we're playing against Twin, probably. And we're probably going to just be dead here. Or at least there's a decent chance of that. We can't cast Linvala because we don't have enough white. We can Chord. I guess we could just pass. And then end of turn Chord for two if he plays an Exarch or whatever. And then we have the Wall of Roots available to use the mana to blow up his thing. Yeah, alright, I'll just do that. I think that's probably better than, being dead. Okay, just doing nothing. Well, I think I'm still just going to make that same Chord play. So, Chord for two. Yeah, I'm just going to still get Pride Mage, I think. Okay, Chord gets mana leaked, that's fine. So now I'll go ahead and play Domri. We're in no danger of dying next turn, at least. There's sweet mana leaks too. Yeah, this must be Tempest Remastered. So Domri probably getting mana leaked as well, maybe. Wow, he wants triple red. Does he have a goblin in his hand? He could. I'm just gonna let Domri resolve after all. Alright. Let's see what we get. We got our Domri bolted. Bolted twice? No. Alright, well, we got a Wall of Omens. And we'll play our Noble Hierarch, so now we have enough mana to cast this Linvala. It's pretty nice. So you have like Snapcaster Bolt now to finish the job. Nope, looks like we're gonna get to plus Domri again. Ooh. So we could play Courser, but I think we're just going to be playing Linvala this turn anyway, so... Alright, we'll take our free bird. And I guess go ahead and play Linvala. Hope for the best. I'm trying to think if there's any reason to use Wall of Roots this turn. I guess there's not, because we're playing bird anyway off of it. Basically under any circumstances. Okay, so this is also going to get mana leaked. But that's fine. We're not dying this turn. That's the important thing. Somewhat surprised that... I guess now, actually, I'm not going to cast the bird. Well... Yeah, no, I'm not going to cast the bird. I'm just going to let... So that way we can block Snapcaster with Wall of Roots. Yep, Linvala is mana leaked. That's fine. This goes like pretty badly for us if he has Bolt, but it's not the end of the world. We just lose our Domri. All right, so far so good. So now is the turn where we have to think about if we want to play Courser. If we play Courser, play Bird, then we'll have three untapped creatures and one wall mana, which is not enough to disrupt a Splinter Twin attempt. So I don't really want to do that. If we play Wall of Omens plus Bird, then we can Chord for two if he casts an Exarch on our end of turn. Otherwise, we just pass. I think that's slightly better. So I think that's actually what I'm going to do. Oh, yet another Snapcaster. Okay. I'm a little confused as to why he didn't just main phase this anyway, if he wanted a Bolt Domri. Yeah, I mean, that's fine. So now we don't have to live in fear of getting comboed off, so we can go ahead and just jam Courser. And reveal Path, which is not a bad interactive spell to have available to us. So again, no attacks. And another Path on top. Not bad. So this turn... If I witness back Chord, then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana. So if I witness back Chord using Wall of Roots, I can leave 2 white open for Path and also still be able to Chord for Resto, which I think is what we want to do. Looks like we're getting cryptic anyway. Sure, that's fine. Now we'll just play our bird. And pass again. We've chord for three available, so we can go end of turn chord for witness if we want, but I don't even think we really want to do that. So I guess we could just attack. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and attack. Snapcaster double blocks. Does he not realize that we got an exalted trigger? This is really very bizarre. Huh. I don't know what's going on at all now. Our opponent has made a lot of plays that don't really make sense to me. Alright, so it looks like Snapcaster Serum coming down. That's fine. So we're like one mana short of what I want to do, which is play this guy, copy a Wall of Roots, and then chord for four and blink it. But we can't quite do that because we end up with two Wall of Roots, Wall of Omens, and Courser untapped after we cast this. And that's only six courting mana. So not quite enough. But we can just cast Finks. We can just cast this anyway, I guess. Playing Finks plays around Mana Leak. Yeah, I guess we'll just play Finks instead. Like, I'm really not worried about losing to a combo at this point. So we can take our time. Just attack with Courser this turn. Alright. So Finks resolved. So that means that we're set up to kill next turn, probably. Bolt our Birds of Paradise now. Well, that's actually a little annoying. It shuts us off from casting this, so I think I'm going to just chord for Resto. I think, like, it's very, very hard for us to get punished for doing so. So, yeah. I'm just going to do that. Blink our bird. We get another shot at hitting a land with Courser. Yeah, there's so much good about it. I think it's worth doing. Okay, apparently that was good enough. Okay, so for sideboarding against what I assume is Twin, I think we want Rending Volley. Probably don't want... Well, actually, Eidolon of Rhetoric is not half bad. It stops their interaction. Stops Snapcaster. Yeah, I think it's probably worth keeping. Ooze is good. I think I'm going to shave down mana guys by one. I actually don't think we want the second Pride Mage, even though they're just, like, fine. And I think we probably don't want to be as combo-oriented, so I'm going to cut one of these and, like, a couple Wall of Omens, just because I'm not worried about getting attacked. And bring in the Burnt and Forge Tender for anger and Bolt. Mostly for anger, though. Okay. Yeah, let's give this a whirl. Alright, here we are for game two. We're on the draw, and I think this hand is probably a keep. It's not, like, super exciting, but it has a lot of fast mana, and if we draw a Resto, we can go off pretty quick, although we do need a red source. I think it's still just fine. We have so much disruption post-board that I'm not really very worried about getting comboed out. Alright, that's not a terrible draw. May even actually play that before playing the Wall of Roots, depending on what exactly is going on over there. Yeah, I'm going to play the Wall of Omens because I don't really care if it gets countered. So we could die on turn 4 here. We don't have any defense against that, but we also could kill on turn 4, so that does seem fair. Alright, so our opponent is just passing the turn back, it looks like. Wait, here comes something. A Vendilion Click. Targeting us. Okay. Not what I was expecting. Let's see if he wants to take anything. Alright, so he took away our goblin, and we drew a replacement Forge Tender. Ooh, we were... Well, I guess we were going to draw the Forge Tender if he didn't anyway. So that's fine. We'll go ahead and play the aforementioned Forge Tender, and I think it's probably best to just main phase the Resto here anyway. Yeah. No need to run into counter magic for no reason. So our hand is pretty bad, actually. We need to draw... Well, we just need to draw a combo piece, basically, to win. Ooh, a Watery Grave. It's not expected. Okay. That's a real big problem. That is a real big problem. I guess we attack with... Eh, probably just Resto. Actually, yeah, maybe both. If he wants to trade it, that's fine. Because Shackles actually can just kill Forge Tender. He can just steal it and then sack it on nothing. And it dies, so... Yep, as expected, Shackles is indeed stealing our Resto. And we're going to get beat down. So we're probably just going to lose to the Shackles. So maybe he's not even Twin. I just assumed that because he'd never fetched a black land. Alright, Rending Volley can at least deal with the Click. I mean, it could deal with the Resto also, but I think we would rather have it deal with the Click. To at least keep those Shackles tapped. And there's no reason to hold the Sacred Foundry. We might need it to play around Mana Leak or something later. Ugh, EE for one, that is very bad. Yeah, we'll go ahead and kill off that now, I guess, or whatever. Yikes. Well, we can board in Stony Silence now, at least. Seeing Shackles and EE, I think, is enough cards that Stony Silence will actually be a playable sideboard card. This is probably going to get Spell Snared just from... Like, he shocked himself to play this to get this Watery Grave into play earlier when didn't need blue otherwise. So that makes me think Spell Snare. Maybe not. So we are still just sort of a Court of Calling away from going pretty deep. Looks like we're just gonna get bashed by Resto. That doesn't help much. Lets us chump, I suppose. So we could chump with birds this turn. I don't think we want to do that. Yeah, we probably don't want to do that. So I'm guessing our opponent is not a twin deck after seeing more of their deck and what's going on. So I think we have like way too much removal. Like Rending Volley is just not going to be good. We'd just rather have path only, I think. Is this a second Shackles? No, this is a Tassiger. Okay. Well, we can at least block Tasigur for as long as we need to. Think he should have probably fetched so we could activate Tasigur this turn. Yeah, I'm just gonna not block this. No need to block now. Alright, getting to be pretty dead here. Still, yeah, we still probably don't need to chump block. We have Spellskite, so like we don't really have to be that worried about getting burnt out. Like, I guess now we're dead to Colligan's Command plus Bolt or something, but whatever. Ooh, that's not actually horrible. We can sort of use it to control his graveyard to keep the really undesirable things out of it. And it can be a 6/6. It's probably, I mean, it's probably getting countered, but deprived. Yeah, definitely not twin then. Okay. Yeah, we're dead this game. But still good to know we're not playing against twin. Okay, so re-sideboarding, knowing now that we're not playing against twin. I still don't love Wall of Omens very much. Like, I think we just want a couple. Definitely don't actually want these rending volleys. I think just path is fine, and I don't even know if we want all of them. Probably three is about the number we want, because we do want to be able to hit Tasigur when he comes. Obstinate Baleth, I think, will actually be good, even though it's smaller than Tasigur, which is a bit problematic. I think that this guy's actually decent then, because we don't have to be as, basically we don't have to be as scared about tapping out and just dying. So like, we can just tap out and play this and like copy a Wall of Omens or an Eternal Witness, and that's enough value that it's like a good card. So I think this is about where we want to be. Avalanche Riders actually might be decent too. Yeah, I'll try one Avalanche Rider and only bring in one Baleth maybe. Yeah, I think that makes sense. Oh, we want the other Pride Mage for sure as well. So maybe we can cut. I think this is maybe still our next worst card. We could go down to just one Wall of Omens too. Yeah, I'll try that out. Try out something like this. All right, here we are for game three on the play, and yeah, this hand's good. So we'll start with Wooded Foothills, which will get a Sacred Foundry, so we can cast all of our spells. Okay, not actually unhappy to see our opponent lead off with a turn one serum, because that means that our Wall of Roots will resolve for sure, which is pretty relevant for us this game. So yeah, we'll get that Sacred Foundry. Nice. So I think we're probably just gonna go like end of turn Resto, see if he counters it, and then we can untap in either Domri or whatever. See where it goes. Oh, well, I guess we're just gonna resolve Domri, never mind. That's great. Domri seems super good in this matchup. So yeah, we'll just go Domri plus him. Pride Mage also good. Gives us some Shackles protection. Alright, unfortunately a whiff there, but that's fine. We have Restos for days now. Okay, so he's just killing off our wall, but that doesn't really matter because we have Resto available anyway. And he's missing a land drop, so that's good for us too. Alright, would love an Eternal Witness. We could cast it now and just get back Wooded Foothills, but I think it's probably better to just play this Resto. Playing around a counter spell, obviously. We don't like. We don't have anything super high value in our graveyard, or else getting more value out of the Witness might be important. But I'm not really worried about losing a value-oriented game here. Another main phase click, okay. So he chose to take our Witness, but we drew another one immediately, so that's great. And I guess we'll just go ahead and plus Wall of Roots. Sure, we'll add it to our hand. And I guess we'll play one. Well, yeah, we'll just play one, and then we have Path and Resto to block with, so we don't really have to worry about click messing with us. I guess we can play them both, actually. Yeah, we might as well get them both in there. Alright, there's two Wall of Roots, pass, see what he's up to. Yeah, we're probably just going to win this game with a Domri emblem, hopefully that would be pretty sweet. So looks like this is going to be Snapcaster, go for the throat, then we path Vendilion click, and then we can go like Witness back Resto, and then on his turn play Resto, and Witness back path. That's actually awesome. So yeah, we'll plus Domri again, just again gonna ultimate him ASAP. Kind of would have been nice to draw a land there so we could do it all main phase so he couldn't counter our Resto, but it's not the biggest deal. Ooh, does that change our plans? We can blow up his only black source. Yeah, that's kind of good. And then like upkeep Resto it, or we could play it and then Resto it on his turn. Yeah, I kind of like that, actually. No, no, the Witness plan has just got to be better. Yeah, we'll do that. And we can play the bird also. So it looks like he's... I don't know what this is. Shackles, maybe? Colligan's Command, perhaps? Yeah. Discard a card and deal two to us. Sure. We'll discard Avalanche Riders, because then we can just get it back with Resto anyway. And presumably he'll deal two to Domri. Which is fine. Okay, so we'll end of turn Resto our, or try and Resto our Witness. Probably gonna get countered, but that's fine because then we can just untap and do it. Oh, didn't get countered. Sweet. Maybe our Witness is gonna get bolted. That would be kind of surprising given that he just played Colligan's Command, which I think he could have gotten more value out of later. The blue spell. A blue delve spell? What on earth? See, he must have Murderous Cut and just not realize that he doesn't have any black mana. It's the only thing that makes sense. So yeah, I'm just gonna regrow Avalanche Riders. Avalanche ride him. Oh yeah, dismember. Dismember for the Resto? Well, you shouldn't have done that before we picked our target, because now we just get to rebuy Resto, which is insane. Okay, so yep, plus Domri, keep that train a rolling. Unfortunately, swing and a miss, but we'll play bird and Resto Witness back. I guess Avalanche Riders is fine. We can get back path later anyway, so whatever. So he does have the murderous cut, as we predicted. So cuts our resto, but we have another resto, so we can do that. We can just get it right back. We go ahead and plus Domri to start. No reveal, but we can fetch and remove the bad card from the top of our deck. I'm going to get Stomping Ground untapped because I want another red source. And we'll go ahead and play our Avalanche Riders. Maybe blow up your black source if it resolves. And then on our turn, we'll Resto Witness. Actually, I guess we could play around Cryptic this way. No, I think it's better to just get the only black source out of there. He's going to bolt us now, sure. So bolt Domri. Well, now that we can't be Cryptic, I'm just going to go ahead and cast this Resto now as well. I'm going to leave this Wall of Roots on 3 so that we can still block Snapcaster with it if we need to. Blink Witness, Rebuy Resto. And I guess we can attack with Avalanche Riders. If he blocks, it's not that big a deal. We can just start it. We can just attack next turn and probably win. We're getting very low on time. It's been a bit of a laggy affair. And at the beginning, I joined an 8-man and a 2-man, so I ended up having to toggle between them. So, oh, I accidentally clicked through onto the Echo when I meant to do something else, but it doesn't really matter. Yeah, we'll just go ahead and attack in Township. Yeah, I kind of screwed that up a bit. But it doesn't matter much. It's going to take 6 here and then just be dead next turn. Yeah, I meant to not click through on that and blink Avalanche Riders, but I don't actually think that's even that good. I think blinking Witness is probably just better. We could have gone for the kill if we'd been willing to minus Domri, but I just don't want to do that. There's just like no reason to. Okay, we brick there. Serum Vision. So he needs a Cryptic at this point to survive. And even still, what kind of life is it? He's gonna like Cryptic to tap our guys and draw a card and then has to draw another Cryptic and still be able to advance his board enough that he can eventually win, which just seems super unlikely. Alright, we got that one. So we will be back for round 2 momentarily.